What are you doing?
Had some downtime and I thought I'd come watch the show.
This is the show. You can't watch it from being in it.
Well, I took advantage of my passes and I thought it'd be a fun angle to see the show.
You thought you would come here and plug your movie two nights in a row. Did you or did you not?
Well, no, I just kind of thought I'd come and...
Oh, I just thought I'd come. I just thought I'd come and tell you the movie's coming out tomorrow. The movie with the guys who are in the watch and they find the aliens and they touch their fingers on balls in the movie. That's the movie we're talking about.
Well, I just, you know, the robot called me and said if I had some downtime that to come by and check out the show, so...
I didn't know you guys knew each other.
Oh, we talk sometimes, me and Jeff,
Yeah, we go way back. Yeah, he's a good friend of mine. Yeah.
I mean, you guys go way back. He's an appliance.
Well, he's a lot more than an appliance.
I didn't know that. What else do you do?
I'm a friend, Craig. I'm a friend.
Why are you talking in that weird sort of Vince Vaughn way that's not really an impression of Vince Vaughn, but kind of is a little bit?
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm just sitting here just doing my thing. You don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know if I would let him do that, even if he was my friend.
No, he's a close friend, and I didn't mean to step on any toes, but he invited me to come to the show, so I just thought...
So he invited you to come to the show and yes. Stand on the bit where I do the show from? Because that would, to me, be an indication. You can't really watch the show from... Like, if you go and see a play, right. Romeo and Juliet, you go, oh, I'll put on a dress and stand next to Romeo, right. Then you can't be... That you're in the play.
You're not wrong. But I just thought maybe I'd stand here and I'd just kind of hang out and just pretend I'm not here, but go ahead and I'll just... Go ahead.
I can't do that.
Sorry?
It's kind of freaking me out.
Okay, I'll just be... Let me just... Okay, go ahead.
Who's on the show tonight? Yeah. Emile Hirsch is on the show tonight. You know Emile Hirsch?
I'm not. I'm just watching the show.
I think he's looking at my ass. Is he looking at my ass? Makes me feel kind of good.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Applebee's. Come try Applebee's new fresh flavors of summer entrees, only at Applebee's. See you tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
That's great. All right. Starting to sound a little bit sarcastic now. Sit down. It was good, though. I enjoyed it very much. Almost as much as having my ass looked at by Vince Vaughn. You know, he disappeared during the commercial break, and since then I haven't heard a thing. It's my new thing. Oh, what's the other new thing I was doing? The dance thing. Have you still got that music? When I was doing that thing like that, what did I say to start it off? Late show? Late show! Any more of that crap and we'll stop it right now. Actually, I enjoyed it. The safety word's banana. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, indeed. However, a great day for the actress Kristen Stewart, who was busted today for cheating on her boyfriend, Robert Pattinson. All right. She was cheating on him with the director of her last film, who's married. Now, this is a lady who's not known for her acting range, but today had to be a very emotional day for her. When she first saw the headlines, she was like... Then she kind of lost it a little bit, and she was like... No, don't worry. Eventually, our publicist calmed her down, and now she's like... for his part, Robert Pattinson is reported to be furious. He threw all of Kristen's stuff onto the front lawn. Then he realized the mascara was his. He had to go out and pick it back up. It was a mess. There's a town in upstate New York, this is true, that are picking up the pieces because several houses were broken into and trashed by out-of-control bears. Out-of-control bears, as opposed to bears that are in control. Out-of-control bears is like, oh, that bear's out of control, whereas that bear's really got his act together. All bears are out of control. You don't see a bear and go, that bear, see, that's a sensible bear. Nothing to worry about there, that bear's just going to the store. Anyway, the town was attacked by bears, and I'm not making this up. One of the towns attacked by bears is called Bearsville. That's scary. All I can say to that is batten down the hatches, residents of Dildo, Newfoundland. That's a real town. Look, we've got the sign. There's the sign. Yeah. Do you know there's a new app for the iPhone that says that you can tell your future by studying your tongue? I don't know. Here's how it works. If your tongue's in the mouth of the married director who did your last film, you're going to have a very bad day. It's a very big day in my calendar. I know the audience are all very excited about this as well, and I'm just thrilled. It is the birthday, of course, of Carl Jung, the Swiss psychoanalyst. I know, isn't it great? Isn't it great? I celebrated Jung's birthday today by integrating my conscious with my unconscious while still maintaining their respective autonomies. How about you? That's right! USA! I know what you're thinking. Oh, well, here we go again. Here we go with another late-night host with a crowd-pleasing monologue about the founding of psychology. I wish I could just take a pill and make it all go away. Well, you can't. Carl Jung is a legend in the world of psychiatry. His famous theories include the collective unconscious, the process of individuation, and his most famous, of course, beer before liquor, never sicker. Personally, I think therapy is fantastic. It combines two of my favorite things, talking about myself and lying down. And when I started therapy years ago, I realized I had to get a couple of things off my chest, and those things were called man boobs. Therapist tells me. What, that's the one that got you going? Like, that's the one, none of the rest of it, not the bears and the dildo, that was all fine. But suddenly, it's like I say man boobs, you're like, I can't take it anymore! We got an out-of-control lesbian! It's like an out-of-control bear, but tidier. I look forward to your rage-filled letters. It was only a joke. Anyway, I liked, you know, when I found out about my man boobs, my therapist helped me. Carl Jung. Oh, yeah. As a child, Carl Jung was very anxious. He would actually pass out at the thought of doing schoolwork. It was the same for me, but replaced thought of doing schoolwork with huffing paint. Then later, of course, Jung became a contemporary of Sigmund Freud. And legend has it, the first time that Jung and Freud met, they spent 12 hours talking non-stop, which is exactly what it feels like to interview Regis Philbin.
But over time, Jung and Freud, they started to disagree. They went back and forth. They'd give conferences together, and then they'd go years without speaking. They were frenemies of their day. And they could never agree because Jung firmly believed in the collective unconscious, and Freud was always whacked out of his head on cocaine. Am I talking a lot? Feels like I'm talking a lot, I'm sure. Am I talking a lot? I think I'm talking a lot. This cigar looks like a penis. You think it looks like... Do you like this beard? Do you like this beard? I don't know. I was thinking of growing something different. Just a round one like this. Do you like my glasses? I'm gonna get letters from Freudians now. Sexy letters. The real root of the disagreement, of course, between Freud and Jung was that Freud saw sex behind everything, and that view has prevailed until today. I mean, that's why today, if you accidentally insert a naughty word in a sentence, it's called a Freudian penis. I mean, it's called a... Jung's work didn't deny the role of sex. Jung just simply thought that dream analysis was a more effective tool for discovery. Thanks to Jung, now I know that my recurring dreams are about a purple rod-shaped balloon chasing me into a tunnel. Might have something to do with sex. I also have another dream about two purple rod-shaped balloons bumping into each other. What about you, Jeff? You a Jungian, a Freudian?
I'm a Freudian.
You're a Freudian,
oh, you
really?
Know that. Yeah, I'm a staunch Freudian.
A staunch Freudian? Staunch. Does that Freudian. Mean you have a constant erection?
Why don't you come over here and find out?
No. See, that's just the kind of thing a Freudian would say to a Jungian, but you are. Like, I like it myself. You're sex-obsessed, I'm the mystic. That's what I always think.
Greg, you're projecting.
Well, I have to. The microphones are very bad, and I've got other people I'm not going to hear. You see what I did there? I made up a joke on the spot.
Some comedy laughs. Yeah.
I mean, not a good joke, no, I admit, no. But it was on the spot. I should have one of my own improv shows. You give me a suggestion, and I'll talk for a bit. Yeah, all right. The audience are like, we can go along with a monologue about Jung, but when you start suggesting that, they're like, no, man. You want to do the thing?
I'd love to.
All right.
Carl Jung said, everything that irritates us about this show can lead us to a better understanding of creepy dudes with lesbian haircuts.
Welcome back to the big Carl Jung birthday spectacular, where tonight... You doing anything special for Jung's birthday, are you?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to be psychoanalyzing the hell out of myself.
You can't do it to yourself. It's not like sex.
No, you can do it to yourself.
I don't want to fall out like Jung and Freud. I don't want us to become like Jung and Freud, like we fall out all the time. I don't want to do that. But you're wrong. What time is it, Jeffrey Pierce?
It's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from a man who thinks a Freudian slip is something you wear under your Scottish kilt.
That was very, very good. That was like crafted comedy right there. That, my friend, was top shelf. Top shelf.
Which means it does not belong on
this
program.
Show, exactly. 50% robot, 50% skeleton, 100% gentleman. Hey. That's, what is that voice from Cabin Boy? Isn't that that film? You ever see that movie, Cabin Boy?
Oh, hell yeah.
David Letterman's in that movie.
Love that scene.
Yeah, that's a great scene. I think David's really proud of being in that movie. He's as proud of being in that movie as I am and being in the movie Lenny the Wonder Dog. Although, to be fair, Cabin Boy did better at the box office than Lenny the Wonder Dog. I actually like Cabin Boy, the movie. You ever seen that movie?
Quite good.
I do like it. It's funny. Oh, yes. It's bizarre. Who would have thought I'd like it? This is from Carol in Greenville, North Carolina. You ever been there?
Oh, yeah. Love it. Love it there.
Yeah. She says, Dear Craig and GP, there's nothing on TV except the Olympics. Any suggestions on good DVDs to watch? Well, let me tell you that there's no Olympics on CBS. We've got tons of, crimes being solved by by picking up fluids. That's how you solve crimes. If you find a crime, if, for example, someone's broken into your house, look around for a fluid. Or some kind of residue. Because that's going to be your first clue. I hope that helped. This is from Susan in Portland, Oregon. You ever been there?
Oh, yeah, love it there.
Yeah, all right. How come you, dear Craig, she says, how come your studio audience laughs every time you wave the email around to camera? It's weird. It is weird. This is from Jeanette in Wausau in Wisconsin. Dear Craig, my teenage daughter is at a big summer late night carnival at her high school. Since you're going to be up, would you remind me that I need to pick her up around 1 a.m.? Jeanette, put it down. Put down that device that you got in Newfoundland. What do they call those things? Grizzlies? Go and get your daughter. Go pick her up from school. This is from Brenda in Fall River in Massachusetts, who says, he did it again. Dear Craig and Jeff, what is the best way to get someone to stop sending you annoying emails? Oh, I wish I could figure it out. And finally, this is from Sam in Mississauga in Canada. He says, what's the best memory of the studio you guys are moving out of? Yeah, we're moving out of here soon, Jeff.
Yeah.
Yeah, moving out. My best memory of this studio is the night that it rained and the studio leaked. Rain in California, and the studio was wet, and we said the show must go on. And by we, I mean CBS. Because my motto is the show doesn't necessarily have to go on at all. But that's not a popular motto with the people that pay for this show. And by pay for this show, I mean... What's your favorite memory of this?
Oh, I remember the night it rained. That was
dangerously close to your outlet. Do you remember that?
Oh, yeah.
That would have been dead, because Jeff doesn't like things near his outlet. Particularly moisture.
Although there was that one time.
All right, well, it's time for a commercial break. Jeff, how do you want me to handle this?
We're going to do a little musical outro?
Yeah, why not? You want to try it?
Sure, why not?
Okay. Oh, let's do that thing where we speak into the mouth organs.
It's time for a commercial break. We'll be right back. Enjoy the products advertised.
First guest tonight is an actor. He's in a new film called Killer Joe, which is in New York on Friday and then nationwide in August. Take a look at this.
Okay, I'm not going to discuss it. She's my sister.
Don't applaud that. It's serious. Please welcome Emile Hirsch, everybody. Emile Hirsch. How you doing,
doing, buddy?
Good. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. You look good in that picture. It was scary and messed up. And
pretty bruised up.
Yeah, yeah. Do you get beat up in this movie?
A couple times.
You like that?
Yeah, by a biker gang. Well, the director certainly did, William Friedkin. He really likes blood.
Yeah.
So I'd be on the ground, and the makeup lady would be putting some, some fake blood on me. It's like this Hershey Kiss, kind of like a strawberry...
Corn syrup. I was in the vampire movie.
Tried to sneak my name in there.
Stuff. Yeah, yeah, I know.
And Friedkin walks up and he goes, more blood, and he gets a big bucket of blood with like a weird spatula.
Oh, right, yeah.
He takes it out of her hand, so she's kind of like, ooh.
Yeah.
And then he just empties the bucket onto me. He's,
Did you?
He was taking it easy on me.
Yeah, that's.
Yeah.
And then Matthew McConaughey's out there. He was on the show the other night here.
Yeah, how was he?
He's all right. He's looking very thin.
Yeah, I saw him the other day.
Yeah, he's doing this role where he's playing a guy who's got AIDS. So he's losing a lot of weight. And so he's eating 800 calories a day.
Oof.
He's gone a little crazy. And for Matthew, that's not a long trip. You know what I mean?
Well, I do know what it's like to play a role where you have to lose a lot of weight. I lost 42 pounds on Into the Wild.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, yeah, but...
So,
wait. Knock it off. He put it back on.
But I know what it's like, and it's really hard. The crew has to participate with you in shielding you from the food. So when you're shooting, you go to craft service, there'll be like four grips that will just kind of turn around and look at you by the food. And then you're literally looking at someone maybe stuffing their face with some pasta, and then they kind of look up at you and kind of like snarl a little bit.
No, you're talking about a bear there, Emile. That's a bear.
Well, there was a bear on Into the Wild.
Well, there is a bear, isn't it? Yeah.
Bart Jr.
Yeah.
Animals count, man.
Yeah, Hey, don't make me out like I'm a hater of animals.
He's
I know
named
animals
after
guys.
A Simpsons character.
Where's
Bart? Your respect?
I have respect for animals. You're the one that is eating anything.
If you had respect for animals, your voice wouldn't have broken when you said you had respect for animals.
Well, you saying that's a tell?
According to, CSI or something.
No. You got to find some fluid on me for that to work. That's how you find things out, because there's fluid or residue. But so, see when you, after you lost all the weight for Into the Wild, and you're putting it back on,
yeah.
You like go nuts?
Yeah, I went peanuts.
Peanuts, yeah. Right, yeah.
Not nuss.
Peanuts. I thought you said peanuts.
Yeah,
you're
a full penis.
Yeah.
It was a steady diet.
Did you lose weight on your penis when you lost all that weight?
I didn't have much to lose there, so I really was very careful about the program I did. I did very little,
Are there penis?
What's that coming to go?
If you eat a certain, type of vegetable, it makes your junk bigger.
Carrots.
Or... Oh,
yeah? Yeah. Especially if you tape them to the inside of your pants.
Well, that's not eating them! That's not eating them!
Well...
It's ridiculous. Don't be ridiculous. I'm asking a serious question about an actor's craft.
Yeah, craft service.
How you been otherwise? What are you up to right now?
Well, right now I'm actually
I like your boots, by the way. Is that what the kids call desert boots?
Yeah, it's what the kids call lame before they flush your head in a toilet.
No, I like them. They're good. They were popular. My older brother had them in the 70s, and I thought they were really cool.
What are you saying?
I'm saying
I stole your brother's shoes?
You called me an animal hater, so yeah. Yeah,
we're
Mr.
just getting
Shoe-thief.
Animalistic on each other. Well, right now I'm in training 6 days a week at a place called Pro Camp, where we do 5 hours of weights and cardio a day.
What are you training for, a fight?
I'm working on a movie called Lone Survivor. In September we start shooting, and it's about a Navy SEAL mission in Afghanistan in 2005. It's a really great project, but they're trying to give me a taste of what some of that training is like for the SEALs. And I don't know if you've ever YouTubed Navy SEAL training, but what these guys do is they're the best, the elite of the elite.
Well, yeah,
it's the hardest training in the world.
Yeah, yeah. Why would you? I mean, isn't acting about, it's like hanging out and then pretending?
Well...
Just pretend you do. You don't actually have to do it. Like, when Anthony Hopkins was in Silence of the Lambs, he didn't actually eat people, man. He just... Just pretended.
Clearly, you haven't talked to him recently.
Well, I know what you mean. He's a little crazy. You know him? I know him. He's nuts.
Well, don't be name dropping now.
Look, I have a show. People come out. What can I say?
No, actually, in fact, today I woke up 4:40, and yeah. When the alarm goes off, that's the worst time of the day because you feel all the sore muscles and you know you have to get up. So I drove to Venice,
yeah.
And I did something called a circuit, which you have 6 exercises,
yeah.
And you just do them as fast as you can in a loop for an hour, and then you're done.
Why?
Well, it's this thing called fitness. And but here's
I heard of it.
Here's
yeah,
the funny
yeah, yeah,
thing.
Yeah, yeah. Isn't it something to do with an infomercial?
No,
or
this
something?
Is yeah, yeah. I did my first circuit though. There were these 14-year-olds who came up from Pittsburgh. These pro hockey player kids, or soon to be pro hockey
right.
playing kids. So they had me, the actor, do the circuit with all the 14-year-olds, and these kids flew, man.
Yeah.
I mean, they kicked my ass. I was huffing
paint.
Huffing paint, yeah. Glue, anything to make me forget I was doing
yeah,
this.
Yeah, yeah. That's it.
And so they all beat my ass. And of course, afterwards, TR, you know, my trainer, he came up to me and he goes, Navy SEAL wouldn't let 14-year-old kids.
Well, I was going to say, yeah.
And I went, you're probably right.
Yeah.
And only later on, one of the other guys at camp said, I talked to TR. He said those 14-year-olds were flying in the circuit, so.
So it was okay?
It was hard, tough love, encouragement.
Yeah, I guess.
You should come with me, you should do it.
In your dreams, man. I'm 50 years old, I sit on the couch and eat cheesy puffs.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't, yeah. But the horrible thing about when you exercise a lot, and I am so guilty of this, my friend enlightened me to this fact, is that when you start exercising all the time, that kind of is all you talk about. So I'll be sitting
really?
With...
I had noticed.
You no. It's terrible. It's terrible.
Yeah,
You'll
yeah.
be sitting with your friends, and normally you're used to talking about nothing, okay? And all of a sudden you're like, oh, I was on my 3rd rep today of my 4th set, and it was just this... I felt this burn, and you could just see your friend's eyes glaze over, similar to how yours are. I know. God forbid, God forbid I get someone to spit out their, you know, chocolate ice cream.
No. What I would say is true. You do anything for 5 hours a day, it's going to be on your mind. If you're doing it for that amount of time, it's going to be on your mind. That's all. So don't be hating on yourself. It's all good. It's positive reinforcement.
There's nothing wrong with you. Don't hate yourself. God, don't hate yourself.
That's what I said.
There, your voice broke again.
No, it went higher.
It went higher like that.
I'm trying.
Is that falsetto?
No, it's real Seto. All right, you want $50?
Yeah.
There you go. Emile Hirsch, everybody. Welcome back. My next guest is a very beautiful young woman. She starred in the Flying Wild Alaska show that was on the Discovery Channel. She's a good friend of this show. She came to Scotland with us, and she still speaks to us. The adorable Ariel Tweto, everybody. Ariel Tweto. Hi, Ariel. Wow, you look great. You've gone all glam. You look fantastic. You got did you grow like a foot or something? A
couple of feet. I've been eating a lot of haggis since I've been back.
Hey, now, did you enjoy the haggis in Scotland?
I loved it.
Yeah?
Yeah. Once you got past like what it was made of. But see, that's so weird though, because we eat like chicken. And
yeah, you live in Alaska. You
yeah.
eat chicken, but you bury it in the ground for a year first.
That's our walrus.
That's the walrus.
Yeah.
I still have that walrus penis you gave me.
Oh, good. I'm glad you didn't throw it away. That was a
lot
of
work.
I would
never throw that away. It's above my door.
What's it doing above your door?
Yeah, it's a kind of sign, you know. It's a walrus penis, isn't it?
Yeah. Isn't it?
You're like
charm.
You're
supposed to rub it for good luck whenever you're having a bad day. I'm kidding.
Good
rub
luck
it.
For the
don't
walrus. Yeah.
Yeah. No, don't rub that thing. I would just stare at it. Just yeah.
I stare at it in envy.
Yeah. Oh, cool.
So you got your pilot's license on the show, though. Yes. You're now an FAA qualified pilot. Congratulations. That's awesome.
It's so good finally talking about it, though. I was getting sick of being like, I can't talk about it. But right. Now I'm like, I'm a pilot. It's awesome.
That's great. You ever fly a plane in the outfit you're wearing now?
This thing?
Yeah.
No.
No, that wouldn't be the way. Yeah. You can't work rudder pedals with these.
Not with these suckers.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're quite.
Can I see them? What the hell's that? You've gone Hollywood.
No, I haven't. I haven't.
A little bit. Those are the kind of shoes I wear.
I wear these in Alaska. Yeah. No, in Alaska you.
You can't
wear
them in Alaska?
Yeah, you can, and then, like, catch a fish with it or, like, a seal.
You wouldn't, well, you'd never kick a seal.
No, I wouldn't kick a seal, but, like.
Unless you kicked it to death and then ate all the parts of it.
Yeah, no, I would eat all. See, that's.
It's her culture. Let it go, man.
It is my culture, because we eat everything.
Right.
And it, like, I was thinking about it the other day. People eat chicken breasts. That's a chicken boob. And then, like, people. It is. And then, like. I don't know. We eat like mushrooms, that's bacteria. We eat like ham bottom, and that's a ham butt.
Yeah.
So I was thinking, I was like,
ham bottom? What are you talking about?
I don't know. I was just thinking because everyone now makes so much fun about what I eat. And I'm like,
you've
you
had
guys
enough
eat
of it.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm putting my foot down.
Yeah,
you guys eat
right.
Weird stuff too.
Yeah, you've been in LA quite a lot. Now you can eat sushi and what else?
Sushi's lattes? Weird, it's raw fish.
Yeah, that's right. You probably get that in Alaska. I
know.
I guess.
I think food, like, it goes through you and it's gonna come out, so might as well eat whatever tastes good. It is, like, it's gonna, like, you eat for energy and then, like, go run it off and then it's food.
Hey, you got me there.
I don't know.
Are you still running every day?
Oh, every day. I love
really?
It. Yeah. I'm still on pace. It's been 12, almost 12 years.
12 years, you run every day?
Yeah. I'm gonna break the record.
Like, because I know you like to drink to excess and
what?
Go out. Yeah.
My dad's watching this show.
Yeah.
Come on.
Well, maybe it's timing you. But are you, I mean, you ever got a hangover and think, I can't do it today. I can't do it.
Yeah, a couple of times. Like spring break in Cabo, that was probably the worst. You're just like, I don't know if I could do it. But then you get outside and sweat it out, and then you feel better about yourself.
Okay, fair enough, I'm in.
Yeah, you should do it. Because, I don't know, I love running. Like, I've never went running and then been like, man, I wish I didn't run today.
Well, that's
like,
true.
You never
that's the thing
it.
I always say about getting sober. I never woke up, you know, after I got sober and went, man, I wish I'd gotten drunk last night. Because it doesn't work like that.
I don't know. Sometimes I feel, though, like, if I go out to, like, a crazy place, I'm like, maybe I should have drank, like, one more drink and it would have been, like, a little bit better.
Well, I think that sometimes too, I guess.
No.
Have you? I didn't know about this. Have you got a tattoo going on at the back?
I have.
Is that a maple leaf?
It's a. I don't know what kind of leaf it is.
It looks like a. I'll describe it to the audience.
Here you go.
All right, there you go.
Here.
Can you see it?
Nah. Oh well. It's a leaf. I'm not sure what kind it is.
Wait, shouldn't you know? What if it's a? It's on your body. What if it's marijuana or something?
I made sure it wasn't marijuana, but I did a project on leaves when I was younger, and leaves symbolize change. And I'm always changing. You've seen that? Like I'm always changing. And then you know how leaves fall from a tree and then they go into the ground and it's like a circle of life.
Oh.
And then I ran the Boston Marathon and found this leaf. So it's like a Boston leaf, I guess.
Yeah.
And then I brought it to the tattoo guy and he made it. Good story. Be supportive.
I am being supportive. I'm sorry. I was listening. It is a good story. You found a leaf and you got it tattooed on you. I mean, tattoos are all conceptual. I've never done it from anything I found.
Conceptual.
Yeah,
like
well, you know, they're like crests or little kind of things. Like
join
or die.
Oh, ooh, that's deep.
No. It's Benjamin Franklin did this in 1754. It was in the Pennsylvania Gazette.
What does it mean? Like,
it means join together against the common threat or suffer the consequences.
Huh.
It's an American symbol.
Oh, I like it.
Yeah, yeah. You like it. And actually, I got it. It says, actually, because I kept going. So it says, join or die or do whatever the hell you like.
And then he goes all the way. Then he goes down.
It goes all the way around, yeah. And it goes, oh, look where we ended up. Yeah.
You should actually do that because I
know.
No,
I'm not doing that. It hurts. It hurts getting tattoos. I'm a bit of a girly when it comes to that.
I like the pain. It feels like, I don't know. It's
Do you have a safety word for your tattoo guy?
A safety word?
Yeah, a safety word. Like,
I just lift up my finger and then he's like, he's fine.
Is he very, very small?
Yeah.
No, that's no more.
No, I would be.
All right, you can do some more. No more.
No, I just would get scared that I'd forget the word, like, mid-set, like, and then my safety...
Oh, hey, have you read that 50 Shades of Grey book? All the girls are reading that now.
I haven't read it. I've heard of it. Like, sounds like a great book.
Well, it might be a little dirty, yeah. I guess.
I don't know. I'm around people all the time, and I feel like if I was reading that book in public, I shouldn't be, like, reading
it. Well, did you get yourself a steady young fella yet?
As in boyfriend?
Yeah, yeah.
No.
Not yet?
Nope. Story of my life.
No, it's not the story of your life. No, I think you're just, you know, you're a little picky. I like that.
Yeah.
Can I ask you about this piece of jewelry here?
Sure.
What is that?
Jeff, do you like it?
Ooh.
Yeah. That'd be a good thing for you, Jeff, because you do that thing with your hand.
Yeah.
Try it on later. I know, it's a funky little thing.
Doesn't it get in the way, though, when you have to do stuff with your hand, like the bathroom and things?
I haven't tried to use a bathroom. Maybe later, I go on here. I'll try it.
How long are you planning on wearing it?
I don't know. I'll take it off after, because it's like falls out. I don't know. It's fine. I just think it's pretty.
It is. It's very, very nice. Pretty. Yeah, it's very nice.
And what about this sucker?
Well, that's
super heavy. I'm like weighted down.
No, I
right
like
now.
That. You know, that looks like a 1960s science fiction movie.
Were you alive in the 1960s?
Yeah, I was born in 1962. I'm old, girl.
62. How are the 70s? That's where I want to be.
They were
born.
Very hairy.
Really?
Yeah.
See, I'd fit in though. Look at man, I'm like a furry animal.
No, you would be like the least hairy person
really?
In the 70s. Yeah. Most people looked like bears in the 70s.
How did you like the 70s or the 80s better?
I don't remember the 80s.
You don't?
I went out for a drink in 1979 and I went
back
to rehab in 1992.
Wow.
Not a joke.
Huh.
Yeah. Yeah. It was
kind of sad. I feel like that was a fun era to be a part of.
Yeah, nah, it wasn't. It was crap.
Really? Were you still in Scotland in the 80s?
Partially.
And in London?
Yeah, and other places.
Can you tell I've read your book?
Yeah, I've read my book too.
It's pretty good.
I felt I should in case I get questioned on it.
Yeah.
You should think about that. Write a book about your experiences so far. It's amazing what you've done.
Yeah, it's quite cool. Yeah. I don't know. I've been, like, I write, but then it's so hard for me just to sit still. Like, even right now, I'm just like.
Yeah, I know.
I know, I always bounce off.
But that's all right.
I want to write, though. I love writing. Like, I have weird dreams. I keep a little journal.
We were talking about Jungian stuff earlier on. What do you dream? Tell us your dream. We'll do some dream analysis right now. Tell me your dream.
What was the last? I always have this dream where I'm running and this big, like, orange man comes through the bushes. And then he has, like, a pumpkin head, but it's not a pumpkin. It's just, like, a man with an orange head, and he's always chasing me. And then, like, I just turn around and stare at him. And then nothing happens, but then I don't know why I'm always so scared of
him. No, that's a very, very classic fear of sex dream.
Really? How do you get sex in an orange pumpkin head?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know how I got that. I don't know. What a reach that one. I'm insane, clearly.
You are.
Jeff, do you have anything in this dream analysis?
Yeah, clearly, the man with the orange head is a carrot, which is a penis-friendly food.
Right. Well done, Jeff. A beautiful Ariel Tweto. We'll be right back, everybody.
If you're going to be in the Los Angeles area and would like to attend a taping of The Late Late Show with Craig Ferguson, please call 323-570-0059 or visit llstickets.com.
What did we learn on the show tonight, Craig?
Yeah, well, you can be on the show tomorrow night. And you can see it again. Yeah? Yeah, all right. Mm-hmm. What kind of dark blue suit? yellow underpants. Briefs. Mm-hmm. Really brief. Purple socks. Oh, banana. Yeah, all right. I gotta go. I'll talk to you. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. Vince Vaughn, he'll be on the show tomorrow night, everybody. We gotta go. Good night, everybody. Good night.
Now at Gardner White, you get the lowest prices.
Welcome back. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the big Carl Jung Birthday Spectacular, where tonight... You doing anything special for Jung's birthday, Ariel?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to be psychoanalyzing the hell out of myself.
You can't do it to yourself. It's not like sex.
No, you can do it to yourself.
I don't want to fall out like Jung and Freud. I don't want us to become like Jung and Freud, like we fall out all the time. I don't want to do that. But you're wrong. What time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
It's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from a man who thinks a Freudian slip is something you wear under your Scottish guilt.
I see what you did. Wasn't that true? That was very, very good. That was like crafted comedy right there. That, my friend, was top shelf. Top shelf.
Which means it does not belong on
this
program.
Show, exactly. 50% robot, 50% skeleton, 100% gentleman. Hey. That's, what is that for? It's from Cabin Boy. Isn't that that film? You ever see that movie, Cabin Boy?
Oh, hell yeah.
David Letterman's in that movie.
Love that scene.
Yeah, that's a great scene. I think Dave is really proud of being in that movie. He's as proud of being in that movie as I am and being in the movie Lenny the Wonder Dog. Although, to be fair, Cabin Boy did better at the box office than Lenny the Wonder Dog. I actually like Cabin Boy, the movie. You ever seen that movie?
Quite good.
I do like it. It's funny. Oh, yes. It's bizarre. Who would have thought I'd like it? This is from Carol in Greenville, North Carolina. You ever been there?
Oh, yeah. Love it. Love it there.
Yeah. She says, Dear Craig and GP, there's nothing on TV except the Olympics. Any suggestions on good DVDs to watch? Well, let me tell you that there's no Olympics on CBS. And we've got tons of, crimes being solved by picking up fluids. That's how you solve crimes. If you find a crime, if, for example, someone's broken into your house, look around for a fluid. Or some kind of residue. Because that's going to be your first clue. I hope that helped. This is from Susan in Portland, Oregon. You ever been there?
Oh, yeah.
Carl Jung, oh yeah, as a child, Carl Jung was very anxious. He would actually pass out at the thought of doing schoolwork. It was the same for me, but replace thought of doing schoolwork with huffing paint. Then later, of course, Jung became a contemporary of Sigmund Freud, and legend has it the first time that Jung and Freud met, they spent 12 hours talking non-stop, which is exactly what it feels like to interview Regis Philbin. But over time, Jung and Freud, they started to disagree. They went back and forth. They'd give conferences together, and then they'd go years without speaking. They were frenemies of their day. And they could never agree because Jung firmly believed in the collective unconscious, and Freud was always whacked out of his head on cocaine. Am I talking a lot? Feels like I'm talking a lot, I'm sure. Am I talking a lot? I think I'm talking a lot. This cigar looks like a penis. You think it looks like... Do you like this beard? Do you like this beard? I don't know. I was thinking of growing something different. Just a round one like this. Do you like my glasses? I'm gonna get letters from Freudians now. Sexy letters. The real root of the disagreement, of course, between Freud and Jung was that Freud saw sex behind everything, and that view has prevailed until today. I mean, that's why today, if you accidentally insert a naughty word in a sentence, it's called a Freudian penis. I mean, it's called a... Jung's work didn't deny the role of sex. Jung just simply thought that dream analysis was a more effective tool for discovery. Thanks to Jung, now I know that my recurring dreams are about a purple rod-shaped balloon chasing me into a tunnel. Might have something to do with sex. I also have another dream about two purple rod-shaped balloons bumping into each other. Well,
about you, Jeff? You a Jungian, a Freudian?
I'm a Freudian.
You're a Freudian,
oh, you
really?
Know that. Yeah, I'm a staunch Freudian.
A staunch Freudian? Staunch. Does that mean Freudian. You have a constant erection?
Why don't you come over here and find out?
No. See, that's just the kind of thing a Freudian would say to a Jungian, but you are. Like, I like it myself. You're sex-obsessed, I'm the mystic. That's what I always think.
Greg, you're projecting.
Well, I have to. The microphones are very bad, and I've got other people I'm not going to hear. You see what I did there? I made up a joke on the spot.
Some comedy laughs. Yeah.
I mean, not a good joke, I admit. But it was on the spot. I should have one of my own improv shows. You give me a suggestion, and I'll talk for a bit. Yeah, all right. The audience are like, we can go along with a monologue about Jung, but when you start suggesting that, they're like, no, man. You want to do the thing?
I'd love to.
All right.
Carl Jung said, everything that irritates us about this show can lead us to a better understanding of creepy dudes with lesbian haircuts.
Bears. Out of control bears, as opposed to bears that are in control. Out of control bears is like, oh, that bear's out of control, whereas that bear's really got his act together. All bears are out of control. You don't see a bear and go, that bear, see, that's a sensible bear. Nothing to worry about there, that bear's just going to the store. Anyway, the town was attacked by bears, and I'm not making this up. One of the towns attacked by bears is called Bearsville. That's scary. All I can say to that is batten down the hatches, residents of Dildo, Newfoundland. That's a real town. Look, we've got the sign. There's the sign. Yeah. Do you know there's a new app for the iPhone that says that you can tell your future by studying your tongue? I don't know. Here's how it works. If your tongue's in the mouth of the married director who did your last film, you're going to have a very bad day. It's a very big day in my calendar. I know the audience are all very excited about this as well, and I'm just thrilled. It is the birthday, of course, of Carl Jung, the Swiss psychoanalyst. I know, isn't it great? Isn't it great? I celebrated Jung's birthday today by integrating my conscious with my unconscious while still maintaining their respective autonomies. How about you? That's right! USA! I know what you're thinking at home. Oh, here we go again. Here we go with another late night host with a crowd pleasing monologue about the founding of psychology. I wish I could just take a pill and make it all go away. Well, you can't. Carl Jung is a legend in the world of psychiatry. His famous theories include the collective unconscious, the process of individuation, and his most famous, of course, beer before liquor, never sicker. Personally, I think therapy is fantastic. It combines two of my favorite things, talking about myself and lying down. And when I started therapy years ago, I realized I had to get a couple of things off my chest, and those things were called man boobs. Therapist helped me. What, that's the one that got you going? Like, that's the one, none of the rest, not the bears and the dildo, that was all fine. But suddenly, it's like I say man boobs, you're like, I can't take it anymore! We got an out-of-control lesbian! It's like an out-of-control bear, but tidier. I look forward to your rage-filled letters. It was only a joke. Anyway, I liked, you know, when I found out about my man boobs, my therapist helped me.
What are you doing?
Had some downtime and I thought I'd come watch the show.
This is the show. You can't watch it from being in it.
Well, I took advantage of my passes, and I thought it'd be a fun angle to see the show.
You thought you would come here and plug your movie two nights in a row, did you or did you not?
Well, No, I just kind of thought I'd come
in. Oh, I just thought I'd come. I just thought I'd come and tell you the movie's coming out tomorrow. The movie with the guys who are in the watch and they find the aliens and they touch their fingers on balls in the movie. That's the movie we're talking about.
Well, I just, you know, the robot called me and said if I had some downtime that to come by and check out the show, so.
I didn't know you guys knew each other.
Oh, we talk sometimes, me and Jeff.
Yeah, we go way back. Yeah, he's a good friend of mine.
What do you mean you guys go way back? He's an appliance.
Well, he's a lot more than an appliance.
I didn't know that. What else do you do?
I'm a friend, Craig. I'm a friend.
Why are you talking in that weird sort of Vince Vaughn way that's not really an impression of Vince Vaughn, but kind of is a little bit?
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm just sitting here just doing my thing. You don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know if I would let him do that, even if he was my friend.
No, he's a close friend, and I didn't mean to step on any toes, but he invited me to come to the show, so I just thought...
He invited you to come to the show and stand on the bit where I do the show from? Because that would, to me, be an indication. You can't really watch the show from... Like, if you go and see a play, right. Romeo and Juliet, you go, oh, I'll put on a dress and stand next to Romeo, right. Then you can't be... That you're in the play.
You're not wrong. But I just thought maybe I'd stand here and I'd just kind of hang out and just pretend I'm not here, but go ahead and I'll just... Go ahead.
I can't do that.
Sorry?
Yeah, it's kind of freaking me out.
Okay, Okay, go ahead.
Who's on the show tonight? Yeah. Emile Hirsch is on the show tonight. You know Emile Hirsch?
I'm just watching the show.
I think he's looking at my ass. Is he looking at my ass? Makes me feel kind of good.
Ferguson, sponsored by Applebee's. Come try Applebee's new fresh flavors of summer entrees only at Applebee's. See you tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
That's great. All right. It's starting to sound a little bit sarcastic now. Sit down. It was good, though. I enjoyed it very much. Almost as much as having my ass looked at by Vince Vaughn. You know, he disappeared during the commercial break, and since then I haven't heard a thing. It's my new thing. Oh, what's the other new thing I was doing? The dance thing. Have you still got that music? When I was doing that thing like that, what did I say to start it off? Late show? Late show! Any more of that crap and we'll stop it right now. Actually, I enjoyed it. The safety word's banana. It's a great day for America, everybody. Yes, indeed. However, a great day for the actress Kristen Stewart, who was busted today for cheating on her boyfriend, Robert Pattinson. All right.
She was cheating on him with the director of her last film, who's married. Now, this is a lady who's not known for her acting range, but today had to be a very emotional day for her. When she first saw the headlines, she was like... Then, she kind of lost it a little bit, and she was like... No, don't worry. Eventually, our publicist calmed her down, and now she's like... for his part, Robert Pattinson is reported to be furious. He threw all of Kristen's stuff onto the front lawn. Then he realized the mascara was his. He had to go out and pick it back up. It was a mess. There's a town in upstate New York, this is true, that are picking up the pieces because several houses were broken into and trashed by out-of-control bears.